Good afternoon, everybody. So today, we are going to describe, or I am going to describe the method of solving a differential equation by series solution. So in the last class, we have studied about what is an ordinary point, what is a singular point, what is a regular singular point, and what is an irregular singular point. Okay, so now today we see the method of solving a differential equation by series solution when x equal to 0 is an ordinary point of the equation. Okay, so here we take the method series solution. Series solution when x equal to 0 is an ordinary point of the equation p naught of x d square y by dx square plus p 1 of x dy by dx plus p 2 of x y equal to 0. Okay, so in this, what we learn? We learn about solving a differential equation of this type, okay, a differential equation of this type by series solution. So when x equal to 0 is an ordinary point of the equation. Okay, so first what we do, first we find that whether x equal to 0 is an ordinary point, okay, whether x equal to 0 is an ordinary point or it is a singular point. Where we find first that if it is an ordinary point, then we apply the method of solving by, or if it is an ordinary point. Okay, then if it is not an ordinary point, if it is a singular point, then the method changes. Okay, so first what we do, we learn when x equal to 0 is an ordinary point of the equation. Okay, so when x equal to 0 is an ordinary point of the equation, so we obtain solution. So here we assume that let y is equal to a naught plus a1x plus a2x square, okay, and so on, plus an x to the power n, and it continues. Or in other words, we can write this in the form of summation sign. When x equal to 0, that is summation from 0 to infinity, ak into x to the power k. Okay, so we assume let the solution of y be, it is in this form. Okay, let the solution of the y, it is in this form. So this is known as series form. Okay, it is in the form of series. It is in the form of series, which is known as power series. Okay, power series. So therefore, it is called as series solution. Series solution means we solve the given differential equation by assuming the solution is in the form of series. The solution is in the form of series. So then we write this equation. Then what we need, okay, y, we assume that y is equal to this series. Next is we need d square y by dx square. Okay, so here it is, d square y by dx square. So we differentiate this y two times and we obtain d square y by dx square, correct? And similarly we differentiate, we get dy by dx, so which is there, here it is dy by dx. Correct? So we obtain these two derivatives, dy by dx and d square y by dx square, by differentiating this, by differentiating this two times. Okay, so call this equation as 1. So now we differentiating 1. Differentiating equation 1 with respect to x 2 times. Okay, so dy by dx is equal to, so here this is equation 1. Okay, or otherwise what you do, you take this as equation 1. This is equation 1 and call this is equation 2. Then here differentiating 2 with respect to x 2 times. So here we differentiate this with respect to x. So dy by dx is equal to, here a0 is constant, so its differentiation is 0. And coming to this term, a1 is constant, differentiation of x with respect to x is 1, so only a1 remains. And here it is, a2 is again constant, differentiation of x square is 2x. Like that, so we differentiate. We get dy by dx is equal to, the first one is 0, then plus a1, then plus a2 into differentiation of x square is 2x. Okay, x square is 2x. Then like that we continue. The last term is an into n into x raised to n minus 1. Okay, and so on. Okay, so this we get dy by dx. Next, differentiating again. So d square y by dx square is equal to, this is 0, again this is 0, then this is a2 into differentiation of 2x is only 2. Then and so on, we get this as an into n minus 1 x to the power n minus 2. Okay, so like that, dash dash dash, like that we obtain the two derivatives. Now substituting these d square y by dx square, this and this value, where in this equation 1 here. So this is d square y by dx square, this is dy by dx, right? So substituting dy by dx and d square y by dx square in 2, sorry, in 1, in 1. Okay, so after substituting all this in 1, after substituting all this in 1, then rearranging the terms, rearranging the terms and equating the coefficients of equating the coefficients of like powers of x on both sides. Okay, on both sides. So here when we substitute those values here in this equation, okay, in this equation, now p naught of x is what? It's a polynomial in x. So it is either it may be a quadratic equation, or it may be a single order equation, or it may be a cubic equation. Okay, similarly here p1 of x is also either it may be a quadratic, cubic, or a single order equation, or a fourth order polynomial, whatever it may be. So okay, so totally this p naught of x is polynomial, p1 of x is also polynomial, and p2 of x is also polynomial. So when you substitute all these derivatives, dy by dx and d square by dx square in this equation, and then multiply these two terms, here also you multiply these two terms, here also you multiply these two terms. Okay, so after multiplication, equating the like powers of x. Equating the like powers of x means what? Suppose if here we got the terms like x cube plus x square plus 2, and here we got terms like 2x cube plus 3x square plus 4. Okay, so your like powers of x means here x cube is there, here also x cube is there, so therefore equating the coefficients of like powers of x is to 0. So then we get the answers. Okay, so now after equating the coefficients of all the various powers of x to 0, then find a2 comma a3 comma a4 and so on in terms of a0 and a1, in terms of a0 and a1. So now after obtaining all this, substituting all a0, a1, a2, a3 and so on up to an in the equation 2, that is, so this is equation 2. Okay, so this is equation 2. Okay, so equating the coefficient of like terms of like powers of x, we obtain all the values of a0, a1, a2, a3 and so on an. So here what we do, a0 and a1, they are independent. So that means you have to find the other values of a2, a3, a4 and an in terms of a0 and a1, and substituting all these in this equation 2, so we obtain the solution of the given equation. Okay, substituting all a0, a1, a2, a3 and an in the equation 2, then we get the required solution. Right? So this is the method of solving a differential equation by series solution. So when x equal to 0 is an ordinary point, right? Okay, so now we see some examples on this. Example 1, solve in a series, the equation d square y by dx square plus x square y equal to 0. Okay, equal to 0. So now comparing this equation, okay, so call this equation as 1. Now comparing equation 1 with p0 of x d square y by dx square plus p1 of x dy by dx plus p2 of x y equal to 0. Okay, comparing the given equation with this. Okay, so then what we obtain? We obtain the values of p0, p1, okay, and p2. So comparing this, we get p0 of x is equal to, here what is coefficient? Compare this term and this term here. So coefficient of p0 of x is equal to what? 1. It is equal to 1. And similarly, p1 of x is equal to, so there is no dy by dx term, it's equal to 0. And p2 of x is equal to what? X square. Now in this case, as we know that at x equal to 0, when you substitute x equal to 0 in this, so p0 of x is not equal to 0. Okay, when you substitute x equal to 0 here, you will get p naught of x is equal to 1, which is not equal to 0. So therefore, x equal to 0 is an ordinary point. Okay. So now we find that x equal to 0. We found that x equal to 0 is an ordinary point. So therefore, let y is equal to a naught plus a 1 x plus a 2 x square and so on up to a n x to the power n and so on, or simply it is a summation from k is equal to 0 to infinity a k x to the power k be the solution. Now call this equation as 2. Right? Be the solution. Then obtain two terms. Here we need what we need? Only, okay, d square over dx square. Only, so find out d square over dx square from that equation. So dy by dx is equal to, the first term is 0, this is a1, this is a2 into 2x, and take other term, say a3x cube. Okay, next term is what? a3x cube. So it is a3, 3x square and so on. The last term, an, n into x to the power n minus 1, dash dash. Okay, so this is dy by dx. Differentiating again, d square y by dx square is equal to, this is 0, this is 0, then here it is 2a2, and here it is 3 into 2, 6, a3, a3x, 6a3x, and so on. The last term is n into, an, n into n minus 1, x to the power n minus 2. So, then we obtain d square by dx square. Now, substituting these derivatives in equation 1. Okay, in equation 1. What is equation 1? So, this is equation 1. Here we have to substitute the value. So, what is that? D square over dx square is 2a2 plus 6a3x. 2a2 plus 6a3x. Then plus plus dash an, n into n minus 1 into x to the power n minus 2. An minus 1 x to the power n minus 2. Then plus. Next term is what? X square into y. Okay. So that is x square as it is. Then what is y? So y we have assumed this. Right? Y we have assumed this one. So therefore y is a naught plus a1x plus a2x square and so on an x to the power n into x square into y equal to 0. Okay. Next, is equating the like powers of x. Equating the like powers of x on both the sides. So first we collect the like powers of x. So here first we assume that first is x to the power 0. Okay, equating the coefficient of x to the power 0. What is x to the power 0? X to the power 0 is nothing but 1. That means x to the power 0 means 1, means the only term is what? That term is constant. So first we have to do equating the constants. To 0. Here what is the, what are the constant term here? So this one is constant term 2a2. Okay, next this is only a 2a2 is there because x is not multiplied, so this one is constant. Then here there is no constant term because x is multiplied, and further if you take next term, there is x square is multiplied. Okay, so therefore here there is also no constant term, so only 2a2 is equal to 0, which implies a2 is equal to 0. Okay, next, equating the coefficient of x. X to 0. So here, what is the coefficient of x? So here, this is a coefficient of x, that is 6a3. Okay, 6a3. Next term is what? 6a3. Next term is some constant into a4. Next, x square is there. Okay, so therefore, we are considering only the coefficient of x now. So 6a3. Then here there is no x square term. Right? Only one term, that is 6a3. So therefore, 0 will get 6a3 is equal to 0, which implies a3 is also 0. Right? Next, equating the coefficient of a3 is 0. Okay. Next, equating the coefficient of x to the power n on both the sides to 0. Okay. So here what we get, x to the power n means what? So this is x, then the x square. Next, this is a term, x to the power n minus 2. Okay. Now the term which is behind this, or the term which comes before this. Okay. So what is that term? Here this is x raised to n minus 1, n minus 2. Now the term previous to this one is what? It is x to the power n minus 1. And similarly the term previous to this one is what? X to the power n. So in that case, what we do here? Put to get n minus 1 term, we want to equate the coefficient of x to the power n. Okay, so here what we do in this equation, put n is equal to n plus 2. Okay, put n is equal to n plus 2. Put n is equal to n plus 2. Where? In this equation. Why we do that? Because we want to find the coefficient of x to the power n. So at what values of n? Okay, at what values of n this n minus 2 becomes n? So if you substitute n is equal to n plus 2, then plus 2 minus 2 get cancelled and you will get here x to the power n. Similarly here, if you substitute n is equal to n plus 2, here also n is equal to n plus 2, you will get the coefficients of x to the power n here. Okay, so therefore we substitute n is equal to n plus 2. So we get that term is an plus 2 into n plus 2. Okay, so here we substitute n is equal to n plus 2, so n plus 2, then minus 1, x to the power, here also n plus 2, minus 2. Okay, so in this case we are substituting n is equal to here n plus 2, here also n plus 2, n plus 2, then n plus 2. Okay, then here to get to the power of x to the power n, and here what are the coefficient of x to the power n? That is only one, that is an x square. Okay, so that is plus an x square. So this is the coefficient of x to the power n, an into x square. Okay, now equate this to 0. So which gives? So n plus 2 into an plus 2 into plus 2 minus 1, it is n plus 1, x to the power, plus 2 minus 2 get cancelled, n only, okay, or we will take only coefficient. So coefficient means we can take this x to the power n, okay. So plus here also it is x to the power n, we write here x to the power n, okay. Now we write only coefficient, so an x to the power x square, which is equal to 0. Okay, an x to the power 0 is equal to 0. And one more thing here, when we multiply this, sorry, when we multiply this x square with this, so what it becomes, x square into a naught x square, and a1 into this is x cube, and a2 into this is x square into x square, x to the power 4. So therefore, and here we will get an x to the power n plus 2 will get. So in this case, we substitute n is equal to n minus 2. Okay, so n is equal to n minus 2. That we forgot to write that. So n is equal to n minus 2. So this gives an minus 2, an minus 2. Okay, then x to the power n, x to the power n. Okay, so here in this case, when we multiply this x square with this, then we will get this as an x to the power n plus 2. Okay, n plus 2. So then next is to get the coefficient of x to the power n. Here we substitute n is equal to n minus 2. That's all. So therefore, n minus 2 means here also it is a n minus 2. N minus 2, right? So therefore, from this equation we find an plus 2. So an plus 2 into n plus 1 into n plus 2 is equal to, bring this one here, a minus an minus 2, or an plus 2 is equal to minus an minus 2 divided by n plus 1 into n plus 2. Okay, so instead of finding a4, a5, a6 individually, right, so here we found a2 by equating the coefficient of x to the power 0, constant to 0. So we got a2 is equal to 0. Next, equating the coefficient of x, then we get a3 is equal to 0, right? Next, by equating the coefficient of x square, then we will get next a4. Okay, so instead of finding the a3, a4 individually, let us find one common formula, that is an plus 2 is equal to minus an minus 2 divided by n plus 1 into n plus 2. Now just here we replace, change the values of n. So suppose that you want to get a4, then put n is equal to 2, you will get a4. Put n is equal to 3, you will get a5. Put n is equal to 4, you will get a6 value. Correct? So like that you will obtain all the values of a3, a4, a5 and like that. So an plus 2 will get minus an minus 2 divided by n plus 1 into n plus 2. Now here replacing. Now putting n is equal to 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. So we get a4 is equal to minus a naught divided by 3 into 4. Next, a5 is equal to minus a1 divided by 4 into 5. a6 is equal to minus a2 divided by 5 into 6. So, which is equal to 0, why? Because a2 is equal to 0. Okay, so because a2 is equal to 0, we substitute a2 value here. Therefore, its value a6 is equal to 0. Next, a7 is equal to a7, what we obtain, a7 is minus a3 divided by 6 into 7. Again, this is 0 because a3 is 0. a3 we got 0. So, substituting that a3 is 0, this value becomes 0. Similarly, a8 is equal to minus a4 divided by 7 into 8, which is equal to 7 into 8. Okay, now here what is a4? So this is a4. Okay, this one is a4. This is a4. Now substitute a4 here. So minus minus becomes plus, So this is a naught divided by 3 into 4 into 7 into 8, or which is equal to a naught divided by 3 into 4 into 7 into 8, right? So this is a8. So like that we obtain all the terms. Now substituting all these, all these constants in equation 2, so we get y is equal to, so a naught it is in terms of a0 only, a0, then plus a1 is also in terms of a0, a1x. Next a2 is what? A2 is equal to a0 a1. A2 is again 0, a2 is again 0, we obtain. Then a3 is again 0. Next a4 is minus a0 divided by 3 into 4 x to the power 4. Next a5 is again minus a1 divided by 4 into 5 x to the power 5, right? Then plus a6 is 0, okay, 0. Then a7 is also 0. Next a8 is minus a0 divided by 3 into 4 into 7 into 8 x to the power 8 x to the power 8, okay, dash. So this is the solution of the given equation, right? This is the solution of the given equation, okay? So with this, I conclude this class and continue the next class. Thank you.